Coming off an impressive win against Canada, the heavily favored United States is on a roll, and they mean business. Mark Millen leads the offense of a team that has gotten better every game, but Coach Bill Tierney knows his team still has room to improve.
You've got to give the goalies credit that have been playing against us. They've played outstanding lacrosse. I just hope that we can shoot just a little bit better. And defensively, our crease defense has got to tighten up.
The Iroquois Nation brings on the game's best Native American lacrosse players. They know their task ahead is a difficult one, but perhaps they can gain strength from their storied tradition to help guide the victory. Sunset in Baltimore, Maryland, the host city for World Lacrosse 98. A tremendous matchup and very unique matchup today in semifinal action. The Iroquois Nation take on the defending champion, United States of America. Hi, everyone. I'm Leif Elsmo. Happy to bring the play-by-play to you, joined by Quinn Kesnick. We'll meet him in a moment. But first of all, let's take a look at how these two teams got here. The Iroquois Nation, they struggled through it, had a huge win early on. That was against England, and that put them in position to go where England had historically gone before, and that is into the semifinal round. Tuesday, Japan challenged for that spot. Japan from the other division. Iroquois won 12-9. They come into this game very proud of their record. The United States kind of steamrolled through. They won 4-0. Never a loss, but two big games that were tests. Australia 13-10 and Canada 14-12. The winner here will go on to the finals of our World Championships. Quint Kesnick will be on the sideline. Quint, a lot of star-studded individuals down with you.
That's right, Leif. We'll be on both sidelines tonight. When we go over to the Iroquois sideline, we'll be talking to a lot of great shooters. None better than Corey Bomberry, who's having a super tournament. He's got 7 goals and no assists. This is a kid who can bring it from 15 to 20 yards. Great velocity, about a 95 to 100-mile-an-hour shot. Look at his production in the previous games against Japan yesterday in the play-in game. Had a monster effort with 3 goals. For the U.S., Casey Powell, the graduate from Syracuse University, he'll be seeing his first action. He's been out with a ligament strain in his knee. Who's the 1997 and 98 NCAA Player of the Year. When we come back to Baltimore, we've got the Iroquois Nation against Team USA semifinals here in the World Games.
TDI, you can get 1.9% APR over 24 months. On the road of life, there are passengers and there are drivers.
The 98 World Games of Lacrosse are brought to you by Warrior. Warrior Lacrosse, providing Team USA with the means to dominate. By Volkswagen, drivers want it. By U.S. Lacrosse, the national governing body of lacrosse. And by Lexus Luxury Automobiles, the result of a relentless pursuit of perfection. We're in Baltimore. Perfect playing conditions tonight. It was a steamy day. Record heat here in Baltimore. But we are set for a cool evening of great lacrosse. Team USA in the blue with the white shoulder trim. Gold trim, purple and white will be the Iroquois colors. Tonight, goalies for Warrior tonight, Quint, will be Hops in the goal and Doherty for Team USA. They've been alternating with Sal Acasio. That is our Warrior goalie matchup.
Doherty for the U.S. playing very well right now, 62%. Hops has given up some goals in this tournament. We could see both Hops and Solomon for the Iroquois.
Millen starts things off with an easy rollback. Mark Millen scores in the first 30 seconds, 20-minute running time quarters, 1-0 United States.
The leading scorer for Team USA, Mark Millen, 13 goals coming in. That's his 14th. He's got 2 assists. He has been unstoppable on that left-hand side, that left wing. Take a look at the replay. Here he is dodging left-handed against Burnham. He plants. You can see Burnham can't stay with him. He frees up his right-hand shot, and he puts it over the shoulder of Hops. A great change of direction. A lot of explosiveness from that man right there, Mark Miller.
Man, nobody's been able to stay with him so far. Go back to the face-off. Number five for the Iroquois. Corey Bomberry. And Ryan Wade takes his second face-off in a row. Watch behind. Coming up, Gaywash Schindler gets a big check on him, and the ball rolls out of bounds. Credit Schindler with the defensive check to give it back to the Iroquois Nation.
Leaf, one of the stories. You mentioned Ryan Wade's going to be taking a lot of face-offs. Peter Jacobs for the U.S. Face-off specialist, not in uniform tonight. Peter, resting up for perhaps a game in the finals?
That's what we're hoping for. A lot of guys getting a full rotation out there tonight, and we're just kind of just taking it easy, and hopefully this game will be an easy one. We can't take it lightly because the Iroquois still has a lot of talent out there that can really fire up a lot of goals.
We will see some other face-off players tonight. Ryan Wade, Timmy Sudan will take some draws also.
All right, Quint, talking to Peter Jacobs right there. Let's take a look at the series history with the United States against the Iroquois Nation. 3-0 they lead. This week it was 20-8 in the opening round, the round robin, and they outscored the Iroquois 72-24 since 1990. The Iroquois really coming on and developing some great team defense up there. We know they can shoot, Quint. These guys can put the ball in the net.
They were overpowering against the Japanese last night in the playing game. Japan won the red division, but they did not have enough to stay with this Iroquois squad. Great shooters, as you said, Leaf. Corey Bomberry, Rex Lyons, and Gaywash Schindler. Schindler really getting stronger and stronger as this tournament progresses. He's number 42 in white. Gaywash Schindler plays collegiately at Loyola College.
USA now in a clearing mode. The defense clearing the ball to the offensive end. We might want to mention the blue division, the division the United States was in, the favorite, the medal division, the traditional powers, United States, Australia, Canada. First watch Volker. Volker rockets a high, hard shot over the shoulder and into the net for a 2-0 win. He's got four goals on the tournament. He is a sensational threat from the defensive end.
He's got four goals, Leaf. Get this, on an amazing four shots. He's shooting 100%. Here he is. He comes down on the fast break. Little pump fake. And he just zings this over the shoulder of Hops. Volker can bring it, and he's got great speed. You see he's got a hamstring little twinge going on. He's got a wrap on his left arm, but he just sizzles this. Very deceptive coming out of that long stick, that six-foot-long defensive pole. Fourth goal of the tournament. Brian Volker on four shots, just on fire.
Iroquois Nation bringing the ball down, trying to get their first possession. Shenandoah takes it to the side. He'll come off and get a substitution. I started to mention the blue division, the traditional powers, United States, Canada, Australia, England. They've been the medal round winners. Iroquois Nation comes in as the fifth team. Iroquois beat England to get that fourth spot. England sits out. And then the red division was won. That's the other nations, six other countries represented. Japan won that. They got the right to play for that fourth spot. Lost a close one to the Iroquois Nation. So Japan, certainly a developing country with some sensational talent. And here goes the Iroquois. J.D. Jones. Big right-handed shot wide.
The three guys who have done the damage for the Iroquois thus far has been Gaywash Schindler initiating from behind, Rex Lyons inside, and then Corey Bomberry with his outside shot. Those are the components that really allowed the Iroquois to beat the English and then beat the Japanese.
The ball was inbounded by Rex Lyons. He's the veteran, 36 years old, number 15 on the offense. Really knows where to be on the field. Owen Benedict with the ball right now. Kevin Finner playing defense, and he gets a slide from Joe Bresci. Joe Bresci with a big 6-foot-long defense stick. Back down to the attack. They try to move it one more time for a shot. Can't get it into Lyons. Lyons is a great finisher. You'll see him on the end of a lot of offensive sets for the Iroquois. Right then, they try to force it to him. Couldn't make the connection. Clayton Barnes settles things down. Slow pace, Quint. They're going to control the ball, and they want to really keep it away from the offense of Team USA.
And that's been the formula when you're attacking this Team USA. Work the ball around on outside. Take your time. Keep the ball out of the sticks of guys like Mark Millen and Casey Powell.
Gaywash Schindler, who played at Loyola College, not too far from here. Here goes Finneran. Fast break for him. He's off to the races. Coming down, point man to his left, Casey Powell. Casey Powell takes it down low. Casey Powell playing his first game of the tournament. Knee injury. Penalty on the play, but Casey Powell probably would have taken that shot because the defense has slid down low most times, Quint, but I think he's looking to give it up, being fresh on the field off the injury.
Nice defensive help there by Mark Burnham. We've got a 30-second technical foul against the Iroquois.
Beat it.
The U.S., they're going to have an extra man now.
We got blue ball. We got goalkeeper.
This is a lethal extra man. Michael Watson will initiate from UVA as they move it around. Casey Powell plays a shooter in the middle. Now he'll cut through. Ryan Wade was on the far side. Millen, both lefties naturally on that side as they move it through David Curry. Now Powell from behind goes back to Watson, who's in a perfect spot for him to shoot. Curry with great speed there. And the two lefties will make it very tough. Inside is Watson, who slices through defenses like nobody else on the U.S. team. When you get it into Watson's stick, the defense is in trouble.
The U.S. working the ball around. They go up 3-0 on some nice pass work. Michael Watson, ninth goal of the tournament, had a big night against Team Canada. Watson there settles in the seam of the zone and receives the feed from the left side. Take a look at it. Here the ball gets up top. Ryan Wade will throw it down to the wing. And you can see Watson loop around right-handed. Finds the little gap and beats Hops. The U.S., they're up. They're looking good on the extra man.
We'll be back with more first quarter in just a minute.
You know how you hear some words and you think you've seen them before? Investments. Right. You manage money. Serious. And you see them again. Performance. Here. There. Not just any mutual fund. Yeah, that's it. Warburg Pincus Mutual Funds. They manage money. Right.
My name is Walter Fischer. I design cars for Volkswagen.
I like to drive them! Marketing people ask me to design a special driver's car. I thought, well, I'll design it like my car. With a spoiler, alloy wheels, sunroof.
Von standard!
My wife thinks they should call it the Walter Fischer edition.
They said they'd think about it.
The road of life, there are passengers and there are drivers.
Mysterious explosions!
Gigantic robots!
Who will save us now?
The Beastie Boys. Hello, Nasty.
Hello, Nasty!
The new album featuring Intergalactic.
Intergalactic Planetary!
It's The Beastie Boys. Hello, Nasty.
Hello, Nasty!
In stores now!
Back in Baltimore, Maryland, 3-0 is the score for the United States in the semifinal game against the Iroquois Nation. Timmy Sudan for the United States right there with a white shoulder blue uniform. Facing off against Matt Alexander, played in Syracuse. Off the sideline, Joe Bresci tries to pull in and collect that ball. Just six guys battling for the faceoff. Everybody else has to stay behind the restraining line on either end of the field until possession. And quit, Matt Alexander has looked pretty strong in the offensive end for that team. And of course, you've got one of the key players right there, a Palace name, very familiar to the Iroquois Nation.
That's right, I've got Neil Palace, who played collegially at Nazareth. Neil, what are some keys for you guys to keep this game close? It seems like a ball control right now, very important.
Yeah, it is. We want to hold the ball, work for a good shot, and take advantage of our chances that we make.
Are we going to see some outside shots? I think you guys have some excellent shooters in Gaywas and Corey.
Yeah, we're going to try to work a lot of the guys open that have the shots from the outside and try to get it inside, too. We're going to switch it up a little bit.
The Neil Palace, who led Nazareth to a couple NCAA Division III championships. Right now they've got to tighten it up defensively, though, as the U.S. leads 3-0.
Matt Alexander trying to get a little bit of a break, and he does. Push the shot on Brian Dougherty, who makes the big body block. And here comes the outlet. United States putting continuous pressure as they work behind the X. Mark Millen from behind looks to cut it out front. Very difficult for the goalie to look behind and out front. Three goals, three shots. Only about 8 minutes gone in the game. We're in the first quarter. Semifinal action of World Lacrosse 98. Leif Elsmo, Quint Kesenick, a seven-game broadcast series that will finish with a championship game. Finneran, big check from Burnham to take it out of reach of the goal. Darren Lowe starts behind number 12, seeing put his arms out, calling the play. Darren Lowe, much more of a traditional feeder. A lot of guys balance, can feed, can shoot on this team. I think Darren Lowe pretty much content just to sit and look to distribute.
He's their leading assist man. 3 goals, 10 assists. But I think the strength of this USA attack has been they've spread it around. Every night, it has been a different player.
Milford Marchant, the player on that one, drives left-handed, made a few moves out front. No slide came to really help on the defensive end, but the left-handed shot bounces in far pipe. That's a 4-0 lead.
Marchant, known predominantly as a right-handed player with great speed. This time, he slides to his left. There's no help, as you said, Leaf. A little slow to help out, and the bounce shot beats Hops. Another look. Here it is again. They'll swing the ball to Marchant. He's got a nice alley there to his left. Good clear out by the U.S. team, giving Marchant some room, and he skims that ball off the turf. Again, a third look. Burnham on the defense there. You can see the slide right there. Came a little late. Hops having trouble with that hop.
Back to the face-off circle. The United States using a lot of different faces inside. Great speed there by Marchant in his role as a face-off man. Morrow was on the wing. He comes off, and here goes the U.S. clearing. Quint, interesting look on the Iroquois goal. I don't know if he's made any saves yet, but in the goal, of course, Chris Hops. Most of the tournament, I thought I'd been looking at Joe Solomon. He's not even dressed tonight.
No, Joe Solomon, 30-year-old, played at Cornell, has played very, very well in this tournament. I was really surprised not to see him in uniform.
He's a big guy, big athlete, 6 foot 260, or about 5'11", 260. He's got 100 pounds on the goalie that's playing right here, Chris Hops, but he has been sensational at times for the Iroquois Nation. Charlie Lockwood looking to get the ball rolling again offensively for Team USA. Darren Lowe back and forth, changing direction. Big finishing shot. Five shots, five goals. It seems like the offense is just relentless on the Iroquois Nation. And that is Mark Millen with his second goal of the game.
Millen can do it all. We talked about him as a dodger and initiator with the ball. This time he's off the ball, makes a nice cut. Already his second goal. He'll take a breather on the sideline as Billy Miller will substitute. Watch the replay. They get the ball behind. Darren Lowe, the assist man, talked about him. His 11th assist of the tournament. Millen just slashing right through the defense. Here it is again. You'll get a great angle here. You can see the quickness of Millen. He's so tough to cover when he doesn't have the ball because he can run you either way. And he buries that one in the back of the goal. Mark Millen, 2 goals already.
Ryan Wade up the faceoff. They make two passes. Watson, low to high. We've seen him absolutely scorch goalies with that low to high shot. That one a little bit too high. Michael Watson behind the goal. Billy Miller gives it off to the wing now. And Robbie Shepp. Back to Casey Powell, now behind to Watson, who look up front for cutters. Iroquois now moving into a zone. One other shot. You've got to see a change in goalie soon. It's going to happen. No question about it. I don't know if he's made any saves so far. Chris Hops. I gotta believe there's another story to that, Quint, whether there might be an injury to Big Joe or not. We'll have to find out.
I will try to dig that up, Leif. But you can see they're making the change right now. Hops will come off. Watch it. Right here, Casey Powell gets the ball behind the cage to Lowe. And again, little lax defense on the extra man. Ryan Wade with a lot of time and a lot of room, and he works that offside low corner, his favorite corner. You can see Casey Powell with the knee brace on to Lowe. Swings it to Watson. Michael Watson drives left-handed. Again, watch the location of this shot. Perfect in the low corner. Great angle right there. Very, very difficult save. Ryan Wade's having a big World Games.
Cal Smith for Iroquois Nation gets it on the wing. Here he comes through two defensive checks of the United States. And Bresci made the last check, comes at him as the offense gets reloaded. Over Sheck's head, watch out, coming down to the offensive zone. Stepping out sides was the Iroquois Nation. They didn't call him. And down comes Greg Traynor. Good lefty, big shot. And a nice save for the first opportunity for Pat Solomon. So Solomon comes in there and already adds a little bit of credence to that defensive end. Makes the first save. Score is still 6-0, and it's very early in the game. Casey Powell behind. You can notice him because of his wrapped knee. Medial collateral ligament. Powell again. Initiating from the right. Dishes off. Big shot off the iron. Billy Miller just rockets that one. Bobby Scheck now looks far side. Left-handed shooter is Ryan Wade. Wade behind to Casey Powell. And there's an easy shot from Watson. Casey Powell behind the back. And Watson just buries it for goal number 7.
7-0, the U.S. working the ball very efficiently. They really get the ball movement. It's tough to play this defensively. Watch it again right here. A lot of pressure on Solomon. The ball from the left wing with Wade. He swings it behind. That seems to be the effective area that they're starting from. Casey Powell behind the back feed. Beautiful pass to Watson. Again, watch the skill that Casey Powell has here. He throws this ball behind his back to a cutting Michael Watson. Super pass. You don't see that very often, Leaf.
Procedural call gives the ball to the Iroquois Nation. 6 minutes left, first quarter, and this right now does not look promising for the Iroquois Nation. 7-0. Of course, the Iroquois Nation playing a zone in the last couple minutes, Quint, and they slide toward the ball a lot. You might get some openings on that backside cut. But this game was much tighter in the round robin. Quint, when they played the round robin with Big Joe Solomon in the goal, this was a close game throughout the first half mostly.
Yeah, I spoke to Joe Solomon, Leaf. He's a little far, can hardly reach him. But remember, that game was 2-2 after the first quarter. Solomon is not hurt. He's just not in the lineup.
That is bizarre from my vantage point. But then again, I don't know the facts. So Joe Solomon sits, and the defense struggles for the Iroquois. It was 2-2 at the end of the first quarter, believe it or not, in the round robin game against the United States. Iroquois moving the ball with Matt Alexander. David Morrow was playing him. This is Timmy Sudan playing defense. See the Iroquois guys, very shifty. Scott Burnham trying to get open. He's got some room there. Reluctant to shoot right away, wanting to keep it for that perfect shot. Getting it down low, trying to find Rex Lyons, but it's hit out of bounds. Rex Lyons will be, again, as I've mentioned, pretty much the finisher. He'll position himself to finish the play. Brian Dougherty.
Big save right there, Leaf. Especially, he was stepping across the face of the cage. Dougherty went with the pass, got in position, and managed to get a foot on that. A lot of quickness by Dougherty. He's a great athlete. Very athletic save there. His stick, not close to the ball, but he got his feet.
Ryan Dougherty, big time reaction block. Everybody's quicker than you're playing the goal, but I tell you, he will challenge the shooters, look you right in the eye and say, come on, give me your best shot. Sal Acacio has been starting most of the games we expect if they get to the finals. Sal Acacio will be the starter there. The United States able to rest some key players like faceoff man Jacobs. And they take some time. This is Curry working around the outside. 7-goal lead, plenty of time, plenty of lead. Jesse Hubbard from Princeton, of course, the coach, platooning coach there. There's a big rocket inside the pipe, just caught inside the pipe, and like a pinball machine, just bounced over pipe to pipe. That is the perfect spot, that right-handed finishing spot for Michael Watson. He's already got a hat trick quit, and we are not through the first quarter.
Watson on an assist from Curry. Again, the ball movement. The Iroquois not putting much pressure on the ball there. Hubbard does a good job avoiding the double team. Curry to Watson, and he beats Solomon down low. Again, watch it. Hubbard does a good job when he's double teamed to circle away from pressure, and then Curry finds Watson, whose man went to double team Hubbard. So excellent ball movement by the U.S. Hubbard recognized that he had trouble, circled, found his teammate, and Curry was very unselfish right there. He could have taken that outside shot, but he gave it up to Watson, who had about a 10-yarder.
Gaywa Schindler looks like he might have been feeding Scott Burnham. Turned into a fairly easy save for Brian Dougherty. Here goes U.S. again. Kevin Finneran, great wheels. This experienced player out of Ohio Wesleyan. Back door again. Easy shot. Mark Mellon racking up some numbers. He's got a hat trick. Two players with a hat trick in the first quarter is not done.
Big crowd here tonight. Mark Mellon, 3 goals already. He and Watson teamed up for 6 of the U.S.'s 9 goals. I was talking earlier that they've spread the wealth with this unit. Billy Miller had a big night earlier in the tournament. Watson, Millen, even Jesse Hubbard's got in on the scoring. Here it is. Watch the fast break triggered by the speed of Kevin Finneran. Gets it to the lefty, Millen, and look at the placement on that shot, Leaf. That's within 2 or 3 inches of that pipe. Beautiful accuracy. Again, the look-away feed by Kevin Finneran. and Millen does the rest.
Mark Burnham gave him a lot of room, Quint, more than you would think for a guy with his marquee value. You've got to try to stay with Millen as much as you can when he doesn't have the ball. Finneran, low shot. He's got rope in the corner, and the United States is stunning the Iroquois Nation. It's 10-0 with still about a minute and a half to go in quarter number one.
And I know Finneran wanted to have a big game tonight. That shot pinged off the post. Kevin Finneran did not play against Team Canada. Very focused tonight to get back to his A game. I believe he's one of the best midfielders in the world. There he is, his first goal tonight. You can see his teammates are fired up for him. Finneran had Monday night off and Tuesday night, so he's fresh. This assist will go to Millen. Watch this shot. Finneran is a natural left-hander. Amazing that he could get the shot off righty and ping the corner. Plays for the Philadelphia Wings. Watch the location. Low to high. Again, right off the post in the corner. The U.S. right now, Tierney talked about shooting and how he didn't think this team was shooting well. Well, right now, this team could not be shooting better.
Well, this game is really turning out to be, how do you read it, Quint? Is it good when you get such an easy, let's project this to an easy win for the United States. They've got a tough win in the finals 2 days later. They've had a lot of heat, a lot of games packed in the last 6-7 days.
Well, I think it's good for the fans, that's for sure, Leaf. A lot of these kids here bought tickets to watch players like Casey Powell and Kevin Finneran showcase their skills, and that's what they're going to see over the next 30 minutes. They're going to see a demonstration of terrific lacrosse, both on the defensive end with guys like Pat McCabe and Brian Dockery making plays, and guys offensively. Mark Millen is going to get the opportunity. As I was saying, Mark Millen's going to get the opportunity to show his skills, and that should be fun to see.
And it absolutely is. You know, Bill Tierney coaches a Princeton team that won 5 championships in the 90s. He knows team play is critical. We talked to him earlier about team unity.
Last night down in, in Little Italy, and it was every time we've done something like that, it's helped, you know, the team grow closer together. So the day off, I hope, definitely helped, and we're just going to try our best to, you know, get this Iroquois game and play it to a great final.
Meanwhile, Quint, nobody is making saves. Pat Solomon blocked one when he first came in, but he's not making any there. If they've got 12 shots, they've got 11 goals. And
Marchand's got his second of the game off the timeout. The U.S. just dominating right now. Marchand, one of the players we'll see a lot of time tonight facing off. He and Ryan Wade. You can see Marchand, number 7. We watched him earlier go left-handed. But he's really known for that right-handed explosive first step and a little jump shot. And you've got to really worry about Solomon and the Hops, the Iroquois goalies, who've just been completely ineffective. Here it is again, Milford Marchand, jump shot, lower corner. They've got to step out and start playing these shooters.
Robbie Scheck takes it from the instant possession on the faceoff. Less than a minute to go now. And my question continues to be, where's Big Joe? Joe Solomon kept this a close game through one half of play. He was the goalie most of the round robin. He's sitting on the sideline, not in uniform, and he was a huge blocker. So that continues to be a question that fans may ask if they follow the Iroquois team, but right now they are in a battle just to get themselves into any kind of a groove to hold back the United States team. 11-0, and another score, Billy Miller. The ball loose in front of the goal. Burnham couldn't get it. The goalie couldn't get it. And I tell you, the wheels have fallen off the cart early. This quarter winding down, but they'll take a 12-0 lead into this break because the quarter's going to end with the United States on a ferocious roll. That'll be it, Quint. The time winding down. We'll come back with quarter number 2. The United States just steamrolling the Iroquois.
Try to imagine every major lacrosse association becoming one, bringing you a better game. Lacrosse. There's no I in team, just us. U.S. Lacrosse. Imagine what we can do together.
To join, call U.S. Lacrosse today at 410-235-6882. Get Lacrosse Magazine and the new quarterly Lax Mag for kids, plus other benefits for the player, coach, official, and fan.
U.S. Lacrosse, make the team a winner.
What is it? An SUV? A luxury sedan? Like nothing you've ever seen. Yes. The new 1999 RX300. Like no other vehicle or value on Earth. Lexus of Annapolis, England. Stole a Lexus in Owings Mills. Papa John's way. Their way. Our secret ingredient. And theirs. You see, most pizza delivery chains use dehydrated paste to make their sauce. Papa John's uses sauce made from vine-ripened tomatoes the day they're picked, then sent on to our stores. We believe better ingredients make a better pizza. That's why there's everyone else's pizza and Papa John's.
Get a large pizza with up to five toppings for $10.99 and your second pizza for $6.
We're back to live action semifinals here in Baltimore, Maryland. Lee Felsmo, Quinn Kesnick, the United States off to a dramatic lead, could be a record-setting lead, 12-0 in the first quarter. And Quint, they've made another goalie change. They went back to the starter, Chris Hops.
Yeah, they did. Just talking right now with Joe Solomon here, who's played a lot of goal for the Iroquois in this tournament. He actually did not play against the U.S. last time, but had a couple great games against England and Australia. Joe, what's got to be done defensively to stop this U.S. squad?
I don't know that anything, one particular thing that we pointed out to stop this offense. It's probably our just lack of defensive experience that is really hurting us. It's going to play together more, and maybe second slides are killing us.
Right. You guys have shown the ability with some young players in this tournament, guys like Awas Schindler and Marshall Abrams, that the future looks bright for you guys.
Yeah, it does, but I know we still, as I said before, we still need to get that experience. You know, like Marshall's one of them. We still get the younger guys to know that lacrosse isn't just an offensive sport, and you know that to win championships, it is based on defense.
Joe, thanks for being with us. Good luck in the future. You played very well this week. Joe Solomon, one of the Iroquois goalies, not in uniform tonight, but he's had a great tournament.
Thank you. That's a little bit of an insight there. I kind of remember seeing him in the goal almost every time I saw that team, but evidently he did not play against Team USA. So Hops back in the goal for the Iroquois. And patience on defense, definitely something that Joe Solomon says they have to learn. They definitely can shoot the ball. This team, without question, can put the ball in the net. Ryan Dougherty looking to clear, gives it off to the wing. That's Volker up to the middle. And a nifty little pass tries to find the midfield wing. Iroquois Nation now trying to clear, and they do. Matt Alexander will bring the ball down, and coming in from the sideline is Dan Berman. Berman on the left as Alexander takes it in from the top against Robbie Sheck. Burnham, very quick change of direction. Sheck has great speed too. Maybe not as quick on the change of direction. We'll see what Alexander does. Obviously taking his time, working the ball around. And here he goes. Alexander looking for the slide. He gets it. And he finds the open man. Now in traffic, back to him. Gaywash shouldn't have put it right back in the stick of Alexander. Not a bad play as they go back door with this one. Alexander, he rockets one. And cut down by the stick of Pat McCabe. Pat McCabe will get a slash call, and that'll be an extra man situation. It'll be six players against five for the Iroquois Nation.
Well, this is when you're really going to see the shooting ability of the Iroquois. Rex Lyons comes in. Keep your eye on the Bomberries. Watch the replay of the penalty. Patty McCabe right there will be called for a slashing violation. Referees thought he hit him up in the shoulder and the head area. Can't argue with that. Wasn't the hardest check, but the location was certainly a slash.
Bomberry starts it right in the middle. He'll take one right from there. Low, hard shot.
Dougherty all over that. He looks extremely sharp. Dougherty came in with about 63 save percentage. He feels very comfortable right now. When you see Brian Dougherty bouncing between the pipes and yelling at his defense as he is right there, you know he is on. When he gets quiet and he stops moving his feet, that's when he's not playing his best.
Too many men on the United States. Now they are two men down. There'll be just four defensive players. Hard to tell. The uniforms are very similar. So white shoulder players are the U.S., dark shoulder are Iroquois. And they try to sneak it back door to Rex Lyons. They had that box. They were playing 6-1-4, Quint. Not really necessary to try that pass through the middle, and they lose possession.
First penalty is released. The U.S. still a man down. Could be a difficult clear. You can see Doherty playing cat and mouse around the cage. He's got good speed.
Team's even strength right now. Joe Bresci gives it off to the United States midfield as they bring it down with a huge 12-0 lead. We're still in the first half of this semifinal game. Rob Scheck now takes it from teammate Greg Trainer.
Leaf, I've got one of the stars for the U.S. so far, Michael Watson, three goals already. Coach Tierney talked about the fact that he didn't think you guys were shooting well. Tonight, a great opportunity for you guys to sharpen your shooting up.
Yeah, we really came out on fire, and we're hoping to keep it going. Just trying to shoot smart, not so much aim for the perfect corner shot, but aim for the net, what you see behind the goalie, and just keep it simple like that, and it seems to work better that way.
Spreading the wealth also. A lot of different guys getting an opportunity to go to the goal. Marchant with two goals, and Kevin Finneran with a nice goal. Depth has been a key for you guys.
Definitely, yeah. We got a lot of fresh legs. We're resting some guys today, in case we get the win tonight, which it looks like, we're on our way. So, we got a lot of horses out there, and we're just a little overmatched right now, I think.
Fun for you to play in front of your family, your father and your three sisters and your mom here. Growing up in Baltimore, it's got to be exciting for you?
Definitely, yeah. I just live right up the road, and it's good to see all my friends out here and family and playing in front of such a large crowd.
Michael Watson played collegiately at Virginia. Having a big U.S. World Games, he's got a hat trick already. We're about 14 minutes before halftime.
And Quint Iroquois dent the nets. They finally get one from Clayton Barnes. Nice cutting play. It starts from behind, and opposite corner cut by Barnes puts it past Brian Doherty.
Watch the replay. The Iroquois get on the board. Gaywash Schindler behind the net with a nice left-handed feed. Barnes cutting through the D. This will be a great angle right here. You can see Barnes on the top right portion. Beautiful quick stick. Doherty turned, but Barnes let that ball get out of the stick very quickly. No way the goalie's going to make the save there. Nice pass work by that man. Gaywash Schindler with the assist and Barnes with the goal.
So they're on the board 12-1, about 15 minutes left in the first half. Clifford Marchant in the faceoff. Barnes gets it from him, and Reed Jackson gets the loose ball. Jackson, an interesting character, played at Rutgers, tremendous athlete, likes to race cars. As a hobby. Brian Doherty looking to clear, very patient U.S. offense. Quint reminds me, this is so reflective of how much this team has grown, Team USA. They struggled through most of their games in the round robin. Almost everybody they struggled with early. They just were not in sync, including the Iroquois Nation. They were tied 2-2. It just shows you that at this point in the tournament, semifinal action, this team is really finding themselves.
They've managed to find a way to win in all their games. And against Australia, it was tied up after the first quarter. The same with England and the same with the Iroquois. And then against the Canadians, Leaf, the U.S. trailed 8-3 and made a great third quarter run to win that game. So they have not played their best game. Tonight they seem ready to play four quarters in what amounts to a tune-up for Friday's finals.
And just like that, the big start. You see the start me up graphic. They had a tough start in most of the tournament play, but this is Darren Lowe putting one in the hoop. And Lowe gets roped to make it a 13-1 game.
His fourth goal of the tournament, the leading assist getter. Darren Lowe's got deceptive speed, I tell you. That's one of the reasons why he is a great feeder, because he can free up his hands. And here you can see his speed as he flashes through the middle. He's got a tight pocket on his stick, which allows for a quick release. Again, watch this. Millen with the assist. You'll see Lowe find the opening. Look at the center of that defense. Just no one in the middle. And Lowe one-touches that past the Iroquois goalie.
Mark Millen, three goals, three assists at this point. Mark Millen, the best player, the MVP of the 94 World Championships. Look at this, 3-3, and Watson, three goals already, two hat tricks. Explosive start indeed. Mark Millen working for the Warrior Lacrosse Equipment Company. sponsors here at World Lacrosse 98. USA looking for the cutting out front, and they get it, Jesse Hubbard.
Leaf, I've got one of those guys who has scored a goal. Four goals in the tournament, Brian Volker, four shots. The day off seemed to pay huge dividends for you guys. You seemed a little banged up and tired after the Canada game. Today, the legs look sharp.
Well, we're really starting to put it together. The second half of the Canada game, we started to really gel as a team and start playing well, and it just continued in the first couple minutes of this game. So we're just focusing on this one and looking towards Friday.
Tough not to play the scoreboard here. You got to stay within your game plan and work on some things that are going to make you a better team.
Yeah, I mean, these guys are a proud team. They're not going to quit, and we can't quit either. We just got to play our game and keep getting better.
You looking for five goals on five shots next time down?
I just close my eyes and let them go.
Brian Volker, the hottest shooter in this tournament. Four goals on four shots, plus he's played great defense, stopping Gary Gate the other night, and just doing an effective job in every game.
Plays for the Philadelphia Wings in the National Lacrosse League. Played collegiately right here at Hopkins, and coaches now at Hopkins. Iroquois Nation now trying to work into the offensive zone with Tony Gray bringing the ball down. He gets doubled by David Morrow. Morrow putting some of the lumber on him and picked off in the middle beautifully. Doherty gets it in his stick, and here they go. Charlie Lockwood putting on the Jets, looking for help. Gets it from Finneran behind. Finneran just left-handed after he beats one player. The slide came a little bit late. Ron Kogan came out there and tried to slow it down a little bit too late, 14-1. USA just poured it on.
Doherty with a nice save gets the outlet pass up, and the U.S. with their speed, Lockwood and Finneran, they had a 5-on-4 break. This entire time, Lockwood had the ball. Finneran was behind him for the drop pass, calling for the ball. You could hear him from here. And Lockwood heard him at the last second, turned and found him. Here it is again. You'll see Lockwood turn at the last second to find Finneran right there. And the U.S. with that 5-on-4 man advantage. Finneran shooting the ball well. That's where he loves to shoot it, to that offside, the left-hander with two goals.
Iroquois Nation facing the return champions, the champions of 94, the defending champions, Team USA. Flag on the play. It'll be a penalty against the Iroquois Nation, so a free shot for USA, and then an extra man play. Offsides will be the call.
The U.S.
30 seconds, 7.
All right, there's an offsides call coming, so it'll be an extra man play for Team USA.
U.S. now not going with their specialty unit. They've chosen to keep the six players that are on the field on the field. Usually they'll make some substitutions. This time, they're staying with the six that were out there.
They've had one shot at an extra man goal, and they've canned it. It was Michael Watson coming across the middle on that one. And here, a lot of great ball movement, skipping a player back door. Casey Powell tries that low shot, backed up beautifully by Darren Lowe. Burnham works the defense on that side. Lefty up top, big shot by Milford Marchant. He misses that big old 6x6 target.
They almost hit the ball boy back there. You can see the ball boys wear helmets, and that's exactly why. This ball is moving 95 to 100 miles an hour.
Back out to Milford Marchant. Goes to his left hand, looks for a juke down low. Low inside, that's Darren Lowe. Into Robbie Scheck, teams at even strength now. As goalie Chris Hobbs picks up the ball. Matt Alexander looks for help. Alexander gets one in the helmet, and a delayed call right there. It'll be a slash call. Alexander's showing good speed as he brings the ball up. Played at Syracuse. Look at a free shot. They continue, the continuation play goes to the ball is dead. And they step out of the offensive zone. Big play inside. Rex Lyon shows why he is one of the most lethal finishers. And at 36, he'll be parked around the crease to do just what he just did.
He really is amazing. He and Gaywa Schindler, who will get this assist. Schindler, only about 22 years old. Lyon's 14 years older than them, but they work so well together. Most of Rex Lyon's goals have come on assists from Schindler. Here it is again. Watch, you'll see in the top of your screen, Lyons park himself on the crease. There he is. And Schindler somehow finds it to him. And look at the spinning effort. backhanding the ball past and between the legs of Brian Dougherty. Rex Lyons, like you said, 36 years old, Shinley only 22, but really the A combination for the Iroquois squad.
Penalty on the United States, Billy Miller, and Quint will have another extra man play. The Iroquois will, if they can get possession.
No possession, boys. My whistle. You got it.
Okay, well, they missed it on a technical move. They moved a little bit early, so Corey Bomberry, who was in there for the faceoff, they might not get a chance to get the ball, even though they have a man advantage. They go all the way back to Brian Dougherty and just try to make the slow move upfield. Billy Miller in the box. A good look at one of the toughest players on the team at 160 pounds. Little cat and mouse, Brian Dougherty, using that 9-foot radius crease. All right, Quint, whistle on.
That's going to be an inadvertent whistle. The box official thought it was an offside.
Okay,
ball.
We got a referee error. The ball staying. Referee error. Ball staying blue.
That's exactly right. That's the right call.
Come back.
It'll be a Michael Watson stick on the far side. Still, they have a man advantage. The Iroquois Nation does, except they just don't have the ball.
Leaf, I've got Matt Alexander of the Iroquois. Matt, great job. You're showing a lot of speed out there. An opportunity for you as a player at Syracuse University, really, to showcase your skills and play against some of the top U.S. players.
Yeah, it's great, especially playing with players on my own team like Marshall Abrams, Casey Powell. It's great, you know. I haven't seen him all summer, so it's great playing with him.
At Syracuse, you're used predominantly as a defensive midfielder. Now you get some time to go to the goal.
Yeah, hopefully my coach desk is up there and sees me going to the goal. Maybe I can play some offense next year. But no, I'm enjoying playing here. It's been a fun time.
Syracuse appears to be loaded. You lose Casey Powell next year, but you're going to have a real solid squad.
Yeah, we got a lot of newcomers. We're supposed to be at the top recruiting class. That's what they say. But you never know. Each year is different.
Matt Alexander and Marshall Abrams, two of the bright young stars for the Syracuse Orange, playing for the Iroquois Nationals.
Burnham for the Iroquois team moves it upfield, and now they will take it downfield with Corey Bomberry. He has a huge shot from anywhere inside the restraining line. Once he gets inside that white line, he's got velocity to put pressure on Brian Dougherty. 14-12, a 12-goal lead, and we're still in the first half. Underhand shot gets a lot of stick checks from Team USA. Timeout called right now, and we will be back in just a moment with more from our semifinal matchup, Iroquois against U.S.
You know how you hear some words and you think you've seen them before? Investments. Right. They manage money. Serious. And you see them again. Performance. Here. There. Not just any mutual fund. Yeah, that's it. Warburg Pincus Mutual Funds. They manage money. Right.
Warburg Pincus Family of Funds.
Jetta TDI, you can get 1.9% APR over 24 months. On the road of life, there are passengers and there are drivers.
When people come to Crown, they want more than just gas. They want three things. They want quality, they want service, they want fresh, and they want bright.
Yes, sweeping is very important. I do a strong forward stroke, lift, bring it back. I have my own system for stacking. Classic pyramid. Can't go wrong. I just want Crown to be a beacon for the drivers that are out there on the road. I don't ever want to leave. I'm going to move in, I think.
Get a buy one, get one free ticket voucher to these World Lacrosse Games with qualifying purchase at Crown Gasoline.
One of the world's best quality automakers to refine and perfect a single automobile for 30 years. And this is the result. Toyota Corolla. It's everything you'd expect and more, because now Corolla's all new, bigger with more power and safety features like side impact airbags, yet priced $1,000 below last year with a special low payment lease available. No wonder Corolla is the best-selling car in the world.
uphill struggle for the Iroquois Nation. They got off to, obviously, a very slow start. They've got the ball now, though. Big hidden ball trick. And where the heck is this? Brian Dougherty's got the ball.
That was a great hidden ball play right there. Dougherty, though, at the last moment, I think, picked it up and made an outstanding save.
We need to make a point to these teams. Went talking to Oren Lyons for the moment. I'll wait till he gets back on his headset because I want to bring him in on this conversation. But right now, Team USA bringing the ball down. Wade Jackson of Rutgers. Back to Billy Miller.
200!
Darren Lowe, the only father-son combination partner. His dad played in 74. Alan Lowe. And here goes USA. Milford Marchant with great speed gets a double. Now he starts moving the ball behind. If you move the ball two, three passes after a double, you're going to get an easy shot. But U.S. not in a big hurry here. As they push it in, big save there by Iroquois. Big shot, and they rip rope from up top. It's David Curry just sizzling a laser. 15-2 with 2 minutes left.
David Curry's
first goal.
Really doing a lot of the damage. I think he and Ryan Wade are playing the best out of all the U.S. team middies. That's his ninth goal of the tournament, his first of the game. This is just a free play here. The ball just trickled. Nice play by the Iroquois goalie there to get the ball on the ground. But Curry, you can see him at the top of the picture right there. No one on him. And then he just sizzles about a 95-mile-an-hour shot. Leaf, I'm lucky enough to be joined by Oren Lyons Jr. Of the Iroquois Nation. This game goes way back with you guys. And tell me the spiritual importance of lacrosse in your culture.
Well, this year I've probably played in five or six medicine games already. In this game, it's for somebody in the community, for the community itself, for the nation, for help. Right now, it's very active across and very contemporary.
Oren, you played for Syracuse University with the great Jim Brown, yeah. And you continue to be a leader. You've got to be very impressed and happy with the way your squad has played in this tournament. Great victory, yeah. Tremendous victory over England, and then last night against Japan.
Yeah, they worked hard. I mean, it's been a long time coming. 15 years we've been at this, and finally we've stepped over the line. I think 2002, we're going to field a team that is going to surprise a lot of people.
Rex Lyons, your son, still at the age of 36, playing some of his best lacrosse. But you got some young faces, Gaywash Schindler, yeah. Matt Alexander, Marshall Abrams. These are exceptional players.
Yeah, they work together, and of course Rex has got the experience, and he was a high scorer in Australia and also in England, and he's still there. I had to convince him to stay on, you know.
Oren Lyons, an artist, one of the great goaltenders at Syracuse and with the Iroquois Nationals. If you go into the Lacrosse Hall of Fame, Leaf, and you watch the video in there, Oren Lyons tells some terrific stories on that video, one of the greatest storytellers in our sport.
And the museum, Hall of Fame Museum, is right adjacent to the Johns Hopkins Field, a wonderful place to visit to get the full feeling of the history of this great game of lacrosse, and obviously Iroquois a big part of that. Seconds winding down, as you see in the first half, the score 15-2, and we'll take a short break right now. The United States just powering ahead. We'll return with halftime in a moment.
Sedan, like nothing you've ever seen. Yes, the new 1999 RX 300, like no other vehicle or value on earth.
At Lindstall of Lexus and Owings Mills and Lexus of Annapolis.
Try to imagine every major lacrosse association becoming one, bringing you a better game. Lacrosse. There's no I in team, just us. U.S. Lacrosse. Imagine what we can do together.
To join, call U.S. Lacrosse today at 410-235-6882. Get Lacrosse Magazine and the new quarterly Lax Mag for kids, plus other benefits for the player, coach, official, and fan.
U.S. Lacrosse. Make the team a winner.
One of the world's best quality automakers to refine and perfect a single automobile for 30 years. And this is the result. Toyota Corolla. It's everything you'd expect and more, because now Corolla's all new, bigger with more power and safety features like side impact airbags, yet priced $1,000 below last year with a special low payment lease available. No wonder Corolla is the best-selling car in the world.
We're back in Baltimore, Maryland, semifinal game of these World Lacrosse Championships of 1998. The United States is annihilating the Iroquois Nation. Fast start, Quint Kesnick, and really tough for this team to come back.
Tough for the Iroquois to come back, but they actually outscored the U.S. in the second quarter 3-2 after trailing 12-0. So they are not giving up. The U.S. has got to pick it up and play as they did in the first quarter when they just came out on fire. They have not been a fast starting team in the round robin. But now they are just looking exceptional.
Well, earlier, the Iroquois had to really get challenged and win their seat in that fourth spot. They earned it by beating England, but then they were challenged by the winner of the other division. That was Japan. Let's take a look. Oh, we also want to let you know that, hey, folks, this was the other semifinal. So if you don't want to know, wait a minute, let me back up. We're looking at the semifinal highlights from the other game, right, Q? All right, that's what we're doing. I'm wrong. Not the Iroquois playing game. We're going to show you the other semifinal highlights. So, if you don't want to be surprised by the ending, if you're going to watch this game later possibly, go get yourself some refreshment. Let's take a look, though, in this highlight package of the other semifinal game. Well, Q, it was Australia taking on Canada, and Canada came in loaded with offense.
Gary Gates got the first goal for Canada, and then Maracek made it 2-0. But Nicholas, for Australia, with the great speed, tied it up at 2 in the first quarter. Gary Gates playing really his best lacrosse thus far. That made it 6-2 in the second quarter. And then Warren on two extra man chances late. Canada went up by as much as 10-3. And then Warren made it as close as 10-7. But watch this dive shot by Gary Gate. Unbelievable athleticism.
Big time hitting too. Canada came in. Johnny Tavares got penalized on that one. And then
Grant, that was the best one. And watch this. Sanderson and the Australian attack in front. You can see it. Tempers flared. But he was the star. Gary Gate and Maracek. Maracek was our player of the game. Gary Gate back to his A game.
Canada won that game. They will play the winner of this that looks to be the United States. It would be a great final. Stay with us, though. We've got more coming up in this game.
From a movie filled with hope comes a soundtrack filled with heart.
Thank you.
Music from the motion picture, Hope Floats. Hope Floats. Featuring new music from your favorite recording artists. Music from the motion picture, Hope Floats. Soundtrack in stores now.
Remarkable thing happened after Toyota gave the best car built in America more room, more power, and with anti-lock brake standard, priced the bestseller lower than 4 years ago. Over 390,000 people showed up and drove one home, making Camry America's best-selling car, which encourages your Toyota dealer to make it easy for you to drive America's favorite with a low-payment lease. But better come in now. We're expecting another crowd.
Papa John's way. Their way. Our secret ingredient. And theirs. You see, most pizza delivery chains use dehydrated paste to make their sauce. Papa John's uses sauce made from vine-ripened tomatoes the day they're picked, then sent on to our stores. We believe better ingredients make a better pizza. That's why there's everyone else's pizza and Papa John's.
Get a large pizza with up to five toppings for $10.99 and your second pizza for $6.
We're in Baltimore, Maryland, the host city for World Lacrosse 98. This is semifinal game number two. The United States firmly in control, and they were from the outset. Quinn Kesedick, this team came out in sync.
And they were ready to play from the first whistle. They just exploded. Mark Millen, change of direction. That made it 1-0 U.S. And then Volker, his fourth goal of the tournament on four shots. That put him up 2-0. Watson got into the action after having a huge game against the Canadians. Casey Powell in the lineup tonight. Watson again with that goal. The Iroquois came back, though, in the second quarter. Barnes from Schindler, and then Rex Lyons from Schindler. And then Curry scored for the U.S.
And the stats show you that the United States really dominating on shots 28 to 13, almost twice as many, more than twice as many. Face-offs they control there. Really not many good numbers for the Iroquois Nationals. When we come back, we're going to take another look at this game because we've got two 20-minute halves. Iroquois Nation looking to come back against the defending champion, Team USA.
My name is Walter Fischer. I design cars for Volkswagen.
I like to drive them! Marketing people ask me to design a special driver's car. I thought, well, I'll design it like my car. With a spoiler, alloy wheels, sunroof, non-standard. My wife thinks they should call it the Walter Fischer edition.
They said they'd think about it.
The road of life, there are passengers and there are drivers.
When people come to Crown, they want more than just gas. They want three things. They want quality, they want service, they want fresh, and they want bright.
Yeah, sweeping's very important. I do a strong forward stroke, lift, bring it back. I have my own system for stacking. Classic pyramid. Can't go wrong. I just want Crown to be a beacon for the drivers that are out there on the road. I don't ever want to leave. I'm going to move in, I think.
Get a buy one, get one free ticket voucher to these World Lacrosse Games with qualifying purchase of Crown Gasoline.
Like raptors, they prowl unopposed through the street. For nothing from Europe doth dare to compete. Their engineers cower and cry in their beer when faced with the new Motor Trend Import Car of the Year. The Lexus GS 300 and 400. Come see them overwhelm and underprice their leading competitors today at nearby Lexus of Annapolis and Lens Stoller Lexus.
Great scenic shot of Baltimore, Maryland, proud to host World Lacrosse 98 in 2002, back to Australia in 94. It was Manchester, England. Leif Elsmo, Quinn Kesedick along with you. One more half to go, and the Iroquois Nation really has to pull themselves together because they got themselves a pretty sizable hole to work out of. And Quint, you're down the sideline with the a lot of guys taking a little bit of a breather.
Yeah, a lot of guys slightly banged up, but not playing too much action tonight. Great night for you, John DiTomaso, to get some rest.
Well, that I guess was part of the plan, but you never know. And the guys came out, played really hard, and everybody here is great players. Everybody deserves to play, and I'm just glad that it was able to happen tonight.
Chance for some of these superstars on offense, guys like Casey Powell and Michael Watson, to show their skills for the kids here, because the kids really pay to see these stars play.
It sure is. It's nice to see, those guys come out and play well and play hard, and I think that's what we want to do from the beginning. This whole thing is come out and play hard, and it's nice to play well, and we're just hoping that we can keep it going for second half, and then come Friday night.
How's it for you to play in front of your two children? This really the first time that they're kind of old enough to understand that daddy's out on the field, right?
Right. My daughter Briar Rose is 2. My son Brendan is 5, and I like to think that they're having a good time with it. They seem to be enjoying, everything that's gone along with it, and that's one of the reasons really why I came out and decided to give this thing a go again and make the team. And now it's been. It's been incredible from that standpoint.
So. John DiTomaso, one of the all-time greats, 2 national championships at Hopkins, and then 6 club championships. You can say that John DiTomaso has been involved with more championships than any defenseman probably in the history of lacrosse.
Well, defense has been the name of the game for U.S. lacrosse, over the history of their dominance in this world competition. They limit the long sticks, the defensive sticks, to 4 on the field at one time. Big-time shot from the Bomberry boys. That was Cam Bomberry, number 19. There are 2 on the Iroquois Nationals team. But these World Games limit the long sticks to four on the field. You only have four of those long six-foot poles. They are pretty dominant. The U.S. used to eat people up when there were six of them on there playing defense. The focus has kind of shifted back to offense, Quint. And I tell you what, I haven't said long pole too much in these games, and I like it. Nice shot up front. And it's Rex Lyons again coming across the crease. Once they put it in his stick cue, he finds rope.
This time, Cam Bomberry on the assist, and they have a lot of confidence in Rex Lyons. Ron Doctor, the head coach, has got to be happy. After trailing 12-0, they're really playing a lot better. Watch Cam Bomberry up top. You'll see Lyons enter the screen from the right. There he is. Just sneaks behind the U.S. defender. He's got such great stick skills. So to make this catch and then redirect the ball past Doherty is just a great play. You can see it. Both of his goals are in redirects down low. Watch it. You can see Bomberry giving a little head fake. And Rex Lyons takes off towards the cage. His second goal. They have a lot of confidence. He was covered fairly well in there, but they still managed to throw him the ball.
Quint, two goals in a row for Rex Lyons. I love the way he just, it didn't matter how fast the shot was. He knew if he shot right away, he would have Doherty out of position. And he did a beautiful job of putting it into the net. 15-3, the score now. Iroquois Nation winning the third quarter, 1-0. Another goalie change. Q, they went back to their other goalie, Pat Solomon, to start this third quarter. Ray Jackson inbounds the ball to Milford Marchant. He is defensed by Matt Alexander for the Iroquois team. And this is Casey Powell. Look at the heavily wrapped left knee.
Casey Powell tore his medial collateral ligament in his left knee 3.5 weeks ago. I was talking to his doctor. He said the standard trail back takes about 6 to 8 weeks. Amazing goal by Lowe.
Darren Lowe picks up a loose ball in front. Goalie was out of position, and he just wheeled around behind himself to put that one in, and basically an empty net, making the score 16-3. A little bit of a puzzled look by Pat Solomon. Take a look at the big-time hit cue.
Big hit at midfield. The U.S. defense throwing their weight around. And then the goal by Lowe, just what we consider a garbage goal, but he makes a real athletic play. Watch him scoop this ball and then twist, realizing that the goalie's out of the cage right there, blindly shoveling that into the goal. Again, another look. Lowe knows that the goalie has challenged him for the ball and that there's no way he'll make that save, so he shovels it immediately into the goal rather than picking it up, circling, and then shooting.
Lowe's second goal of the game.
Like that.
Leaf, you mentioned in one of our earlier games about his father, Alan Lowe, a member of the 1974 U.S. team. The first father-son combination in U.S. lacrosse history.
Done Achilles.
Going back to the face-off circle. Head referee looks like he sustained an injury, Quint.
He's got his Achilles wrapped.
A little bit of an injury to our head referee. Sounds a little bit like the tape room of the truck. Terry Curry. U.S. dominating faceoffs, pretty much in control throughout. Charlie Lockwood showing great speed. Two players, now three on him. Nice check by the defense of the Iroquois Nationals. That was Cal Smith coming, number 24. And here they go back the other way. Big size on the sideline by Shenandoah. Just knocks himself through the check of Charlie Lockwood. This is Gaywash Schindler. Part of that fabled attack, the offense of the Loyola Greyhounds. They went to the finals. Gaywash Schindler, part of that. They really have a load of offense on the Loyola Greyhounds, and Gaywash played against the best, Quint, and that has helped this national team.
Yeah, it really has. Gaywash struggled in their opening game against Australia, but immediately picked up his game and realized that he was going to have to play his best lacrosse of his career. Had a great game, was really instrumental in the Iroquois beating England 10-9. And he has played like a star since that first game. I think he came out not really knowing what the level of competition was going to be in this tournament, but he has fit in and he has excelled for the Iroquois.
J.D. Jones trying to get a big shot off. He beats Hubbard. Hubbard down there playing a little bit of defense. Normally a strict attackman. So watch number 16. He was matched up there. They had a good matchup they liked. J.D. Jones against 16. Now they don't take advantage of that matchup. Here's Hubbard making a slide. Big hit by Hubbard. Nice job. Another Princeton grad, Dave Morrow, off and running. Ball coming in, slide behind. It was actually Pat McCabe. I had the numbers wrong. Two passes for U.S., Quint, and they are in the hole with the next goal of the game.
And Casey Powell gets his name in the scorebook. You can see the big smile from the Syracuse graduate. Casey Powell at the tail end of that fast break. It was McCabe to Marchant to Casey Powell. You can see, not at full strength. Coach Tierney says he's at about 80%, which is about 100 for everyone else.
Pat McCabe.
Multiple fakes. McCabe to Marchant down low to Casey Powell. Again, watch the fast break. Marchant does a good job sucking the defense towards him, leaving Casey Powell all alone. And you can see he's got that left knee heavily wrapped. Very excited. Coach Tierney talked about how positive Casey has stayed throughout this world team experience. The injury has kept him out. He's seeing his first action tonight. But he's been extremely positive with his teammates.
And maybe the most exciting thing I've been most impressed with of an individual is how Casey Powell has handled his injury. I mean, this guy could have pouted and could have walked away, and he's just been so supportive of the other guys, looking forward to this game. He's going to finally get to play him tonight, and we're really excited to have him out there.
So Bill Tierney talking about Casey Powell and how impressed he was with his attitude, and I have to echo the sentiment. Got my 9-year-old son Nicholas here, and I tell you what, they have buddied up a little bit. That's how great Casey Powell is. He's struggling with the injury, he's playing, he's practicing, but he is always taking time to be good to the kids, shaking the hands, talking to them, knowing their names. It has been a great experience for all the youth that are here, not only watching the great players, but interacting with them throughout the 10-day tournament. Iroquois, 17-3 the score. They're down by 2 touchdowns. 13 minutes left, third quarter. Matt Alexander, great speed, comes in. Big right-handed shot, wide of the mark.
You know, Matt Alexander mentioned getting the opportunity to play offensive midfield, and his coach, John Desko, here in the crowd. And you can see with that explosive first step, I would not be surprised to see Alexander playing some midfield for Syracuse next year. This year, primarily used as a defensive specialist, but a talented player, Leaf.
No question about it. John Desko taking over at Syracuse University for Roy Simmons Jr. Locked on the far side, trying to get an open shot as they come in for another push. Burnham against the defensive checks of Timmy Sudan for the United States. And Sudan finally gets a check on the stick. Ball dislodged and pushed. Robbie Sheck locks up defensively back in the corner. Not the easiest numbers game to do, folks. I don't know how you are seeing it on your monitors, but the yellow on white isn't easy to see, and the U.S. numbers are very close, so I'm giving myself a little bit of an excuse, but numbers aren't easy. David Morrow now playing defense against Matt Alexander, and Gaywa Schindler now locks up front. Timmy Sudan beats him on the left. They go to pick, can't get the open shot, but now that one taken. Sounds like it got a little ping off the pipe. Brian Dougherty picks up, looks immediately for an outlet, and here they go. Fast-running U.S. team, Greg Trader, number 21. Robbie Sheck to his left. Trainer will take it. Big shot goes wide of the goal. He had a lot of options there, Quint. Took the shot, just missed.
Trainer certainly not afraid to shoot. One of the best shooters on that jump shot. He's got that big left hand. He's got a big pocket. And he takes that stick real far back and deceptive coming out of that pocket. Much like a pitcher in baseball with a big curve ball. The ball is just tough to pick up coming out of his stick.
Robert Sheck gets it behind Casey Powell now, driving behind Miller. Miller takes it at the point behind. Powell up top. Robbie Sheck all the way over, and a big five-hole shot. Beautiful job.
Pat Solomon got a foot on that. Trainer, he had a beat. He had the stick beat, but Solomon, little kick save. Playing much better since the first quarter. They've switched their goalie, Hops initially, then Solomon, then Hops, and now we're back to Solomon. Musical goalies.
Sudan gets the ball checked out of his stick. Still loose, going to midfield, can't cross that line, nobody does. And Rick Jackson can't get his handle on that ball, goes out of bounds. Here come the Iroquois national team. 17-3, halfway through the third period. Couple guys that are normally regulars, Quint, in uniform, taking the day off, like Mark Millen. He's on the sideline without a helmet, so is Brian Vogler. So fresh legs for them in the final game as they look like they will be moving on to face Canada.
Yeah, coach.
Yeah.
We've got one of those guys who's been a scoring threat this entire World Games. David Curry, your shooting in this tournament has just been incredible.
Not quite incredible. I've had a bunch of opportunities, but the whole team's shooting real well. We're concentrating on it a lot in practice, and tonight it's paying off.
You seem to be one of the cutters. Most of your goals have really scored on cuts from feet, from behind. If we got a lot of young viewers. How do you find that space? How do you free up your shot?
I think a lot of times after you move the ball, your defenseman might relax a little bit. So I try and take advantage of him turning his head after I move the ball and maybe looking at the back of his helmet. And whenever you see it, you may be able to get a jump cut on him. It's really important to think about that.
We've got a U.S. goal. Leaf?
Well, it was Casey Powell very nonchalantly, I believe from low, but he just goes behind his back, Quint, and knocks that one down. It's Powell from low, and they are up to 18 goals.
Casey Powell, one of the flashiest players in lacrosse. That's Finneran, gets the ball behind the cage to low. Powell catches it right-handed, puts it behind his back. In that situation, it actually increases his angle, and Casey Powell, from a behind-the-back standpoint, has an actually very fast shot behind the back. Most guys just shovel it. Casey puts some zip on it, and that's his second goal. Number 22, a famed number in Syracuse lacrosse history.
Two-time player of the year, as you mentioned, in the Open, and certainly disappointed by the injury, but glad he's out there tonight. They may need him in the finals. Face-off won by the Iroquois national team. They are 15 down at 18-3. Big shot from outside. Monster shot, easily blocked by Brian Diving. Look at the speed by Kevin Finneran. Finneran playing at the top of his game. Good check from behind. Iroquois Gaywa Schindler really hacking him in. Made a nice accurate check to get it down, but still they maintain control, getting it all the way back to Casey Powell. Wearing a lot of elastic on his left knee. Hasn't really had to test the stop and go and the cutting, which would really be the fear point, I think, for him. Quinn, so this is a pretty good start to come back into play.
Yeah, we have not seen Casey as a dodger. He's such a shifty dodger. He can change directions and pop back and forth, and that's really how he hurt his knee. But we're not going to see him in that role tonight. He's going to be mainly a perimeter player for some shots and a guy who's going to operate from behind the goal.
His finishing shots might be cuts like he just made, where he's just coming off a pick, not changing direction. But he has made his mark. His marquee value came from his creative ability. So you won't see what Quint was alluding to, the creative nature of Casey Powell's shooting ability. Ryan Dougherty looking for the ball. Can't find it. Gaywa Schindler does and can't believe it. He missed the goal. Schindler had a nice screen on Dougherty. Dougherty had no idea where Schindler was, I don't think. And he wrapped the shot around the defense. Couldn't find the mark.
Looked like he rushed it a bit.
Being pushed inside, nice job by the Iroquois Nationals to push Zach Coburn right into the crease and score goal number four.
Great inside roll, Neil Palace, who we talked to earlier, 23 years old out of Nazareth, he's a left-hander. Watch, this is just a textbook inside roll. You'll see him come around the cage left-handed and watch him bump Zach Coburn with the body. Right here, you'll see him get inside the stick right there, and that gets Coburn off balance. Palace protects his stick, brings it. Dougherty just leans off of the pipe. Cardinals send for a goalie to come off that pipe, and Palace sneaks it between he and the pipe. Nice goal by Neil Palace.
Really worked Zach beautifully. And we've got 6:12 left.
That type of move, Leaf, a lot more common now in lacrosse, where the attackman generates the contact and then kind of bounces off of the defender.
Taking away that 6-foot advantage. When you stay away from the guy applying the checks, you're usually in a little bit more danger. Close the distance and then dictate which way you're going to go.
Get inside that stick. Tough to make a check when a guy's leaning right up against your body.
U.S. now with a lot of motion before Marchant. Great speed, and Marchant takes it high over the goal and the stick of Pat Solomon. Face-off this quarter dominated by the United States. In this quarter, 6-0 U.S. Robbie Scheck! That was a 100-mile-an-hour laser that he, again, missed the cage location. A little bit of a problem. If there's any problems at all, Quint, they're just missing the goal.
Leaf, I got a guy the other night against Team Canada, had 8 crown balls, an exceptional game. Patty, at the end of that game, you were running circles around the Canadian attack. Fitness right now and your speed, really a key for this American defense.
I wouldn't say we were running circles around him. I just think that we started to get a real good feel for where the ball was going to be. Our defense started to respond pretty well. you know, our defense and our midfields, we got on the loose ball pretty good, and, you know, we turned it into goal.
You're known as a takeaway defender, yet you seem to have grasped Coach Tierney's system now and seem to be really thriving in his system.
Well, I enjoy his system. I have a lot of respect for his theory and the way he wants to play the game, and for me to go out and really try to take the ball away from guys and run around after guys really wouldn't work for our team. So the idea is to win, and if I have to go and sacrifice some of my style, as other guys have done on this team, for the team system, then that's what we're going to do.
You guys picking up that system? You seem a lot more comfortable with it tonight, and you seem defensively to get better every game.
I think so. You know, you have to get acclimated to the system, and everyone has to get used to each other, and that takes some time. And, you know, practice is one thing, but when you get in game situations, it's a big difference, and that's what's starting to happen.
Matty McCabe, who played such a great game the other night against the Canadians, 8 ground balls, made play after play in the third and fourth quarter when the U.S. shut the door on the Canadians.
I will echo that. I think he is as good as they get on the defensive end of the field right now. He is the top of his game. And when you turn him loose in an uncontrolled defensive scheme, he will absolutely strip you of the lacrosse ball. Timeout on the field. We've got 4 minutes left, quarter number three. The U.S. in a comfortable position with a 14-goal lead.
You know how you hear some words and you think you've seen them before? Investments. Right. They manage money. Series. And you see them again. Performance. Here. There. Not just any mutual fund. Yeah, that's it. Warburg Pincus Mutual Funds. They manage money. Right.
Warburg Pincus Family of Funds.
Goal lead for USA. Lee Felsmo, Quint Kesnick. We're in the third quarter of this semifinal matchup for World Lacrosse 98. We're in Baltimore, Maryland, but the best players in the world are here from 11 different countries. Late call against the Iroquois team, and the United States will get a free shot if they can keep possession before they get the potential extra man play. Finneran looking to give it up. He's got a great vision of the field and can really distribute the ball. There's the call being made. Our head referee not on the field because he's injured. Take a look at some of the international rules as we get set for this extra man play. 4 20-minute running quarters. This is international rules, a little different than maybe the NCAA collegiate rules you've used to be seeing. They stopped only in the last 3 minutes of the fourth quarter. Substitutions always on the fly. Quick restarts, you see them all the time. Only 4 long sticks, the 6-foot poles that are primarily defensive, or they are designed for defense.
Love that rule, Leaf. We're both real in favor of that rule, taking the long sticks off the field. And the other difference is the overtime. You play 2 mandatory 4-minute overtime periods, then followed by a sudden death. We only had 1 overtime game in these World Games. It was an exceptional contest. Scotland victorious over Sweden, I think. Over the Czech Republic, actually. This game, nowhere close to being overtime, but you never know about Friday's finals.
That promises to be just an unbelievable game. And this is our 6 of 7 broadcast. We're in it right now, and Quint, to prove the point about the long sticks, I haven't said long, we haven't had to talk about it. We're talking about offensive players, which is refreshing. Michael Watson. This is the extra man play. Well, they're all leaving now, we say. We've got 2 men in the box, 1 from each team, so 2 penalties. Teams are at even strength on the field. 5 guys on 5. Now, U.S. penalty up first, so they will be they will be extra for just a few moments. This is Casey Powell, works behind to Watson, way up front, picked up, big time shot, 5-hole, he cans it. Beautiful job by Greg Trainer. Trainer came in off the penalty bench, and Quint didn't take long to get into the rotation.
No, the Iroquois had problems finding him. He was left all alone. Watson got the ball up. Trainer made a nice catch. It was a high feed. Stopped, planted, and just let it go. So we call a worm burner. Watch this ball sizzle on the turf. Watson with the assist right there. Trainer, you'll see him make a great catch right there. Matt Alexander kind of thrown off by that. And he beats the Iroquois goalie down low. Trainer played at Virginia, lives in the Philadelphia area right now.
Less than 2 minutes to go in quarter number three. A 15-goal lead for Team USA. Robbie Scheck pulls it in from the wing. Being run very hard by the defense of the Iroquois. Taking their time now, working front ball from behind. This is Casey Powell. Greg Trainer just scored. He has possession here to Milford Marchant. A lot of speed. Trainer, the natural lefty, Milford Marchant, naturally righty, but field players adept at either one. Watson from behind. Trainer driving the left through three players, misses the check, big shot coming! And a ball that just misses. Robbie Scheck's had two cannonball shots, Quint, and he's missed the net both times, but I don't think the goalie had anything to do with either of those shots.
Got to be on goal to score. Scheck's got to take something off that shot. It doesn't need to be going 100 miles an hour.
Marchant with that much time left. About 15 seconds. Watson up front. Watch out. There's Billy Miller redirecting. He uses the left hand from the crease to put it right in the corner. Tremendous location. Miller makes it a 20-goal game for Team USA.
And I had a great angle right there. Billy Miller sticking the ball in the corner.
We'll take a short break, come back with quarter number four. Miller makes it 20-4 USA.
Try to imagine every major lacrosse association becoming one, bringing you a better game. Lacrosse. There's no I in team, just us. U.S. Lacrosse. Imagine what we can do together.
To join, call U.S. Lacrosse today at 410-235-6882. Get Lacrosse Magazine and the new quarterly Lax Mag for kids, plus other benefits for the player, coach, official, and fan.
U.S. Lacrosse. Make the team a winner.
Papa John's way. Their way. Our secret ingredient. And theirs. You see, most pizza delivery chains use dehydrated paste to make their sauce. Papa John's uses sauce made from vine-ripened tomatoes the day they're picked, then sent on to our stores. We believe better ingredients make a better pizza. That's why there's everyone else's pizza and Papa John's.
Get a large pizza with up to five toppings for $10.99 and your second pizza for $6.
Like raptors, they prowl unopposed through the street. For nothing from Europe doth dare to compete. Their engineers cower and cry in their beer when faced with the new Motor Trend Import Car of the Year. The Lexus GS 300 and 400. Come see them overwhelm and underprice their leading competitors today at nearby Landstuhler Lexus and Owings Mills and Lexus of Annapolis.
Back in Baltimore, the Lacrosse Museum, just adjacent to the field. And the showcase is the World Lacrosse 98, the international competition right here in Baltimore. Very comfortable night, great playing conditions. Right now, a lot of heat, though, on the Iroquois Nationals. They are down by 16 goals. Got a bad start against a very powerful team. And Quentin, I think that was the situation. Neither goalie got comfortable early, and before they looked up, it was 10-0.
Actually 12-0 even. It was 6-0 before they even made a save. This one was over before it started.
20 minutes to go, running time. Here comes Patty McCabe. Talks to Milford Marchant to his left, gets him out on the point. They dish down low. Oh, and they cannot collect the ball. It was Darren Lowe. Took his eye off it for a second, didn't handle it cleanly, and that is the end of the fast break. Boy, McCabe was directing traffic on that one. They go behind to Billy Miller. Down low, a lot of minutes back there as the quarterback of this team. Kevin Finneran. And here comes the defense of the Iroquois playing behind the goal. Kogan. Finneran now initiates up front. Big check and a foul on Barnes. Clayton Barnes had the move. And what a shot behind the back. Coming across the crease was Billy Miller and dumped it behind his back. Another goal to start the fourth quarter for Team USA.
Billy Miller, usually just a vanilla type player on offense. Rarely do you see the behind the backs and the fancy schmancy type plays. Sheckle got this assist to Billy Miller. Watch it. Little shovel shot behind. That's a great time for that shot. Billy Miller, a little showtime. You don't see that much. Miller won 4 national championships at Hobart University in upstate New York. Lives in the Philadelphia area. Plays for the Philadelphia Wings. Beautiful goal right there. Nice feed by Sheck.
Billy Miller ended the third quarter with a goal. Begins the fourth quarter with one. 2 in a row for him. 20-6 before this faceoff in favor of USA. Look at the speed by Marchant. Working it down to Powell and a dunk. Great save. Beautiful job by Pat Solomon in the goal. That was a slam dunk by Lowe, but Solomon read it beautifully.
Stick on stick, that's what they teach young goalies. Player comes in with that stick high. As a goaltender, you want to match your stick to the shooter's stick. And that time, Lowe just put that ball right in the big goalie stick of Solomon. Beautiful save. His best of the game.
So that gives you an offensive set on the opposite end of the field. And working on the near side, Al Jones, 22, gets it up top. Trying to work it in was number 5, Corey Bomberry. Ball pushed all around. Cam Bomberry running with this unit. Ball was loose. Still loose. Marchant gets it in to Brian Dougherty. Very, very close to being intercepted by Neil Palace. Ball still loose. Watch out. Darren Lowe redirects very quickly. Pat McCabe picked it up, and he cannot make the connection.
A little showtime by Pat McCabe. Trying to walk the dog on that one. He flipped it out of bounds. Patty McCabe in the late 80s, really one of the main defensive players in the Petromala era that kind of transformed the view of a defenseman. In the middle, late 70s, middle 80s, defensemen never really were that aggressive with the ball. But guys like McCabe, Petromala came along, they pushed the tempo, pushed the fast break, proving that a defenseman can score goals and really be an offensive threat as well.
Joe Bresci working on the defensive end. Can't get a clean check, but the ball falls out. Great body check, actually. Didn't use the stick, but Bresci really laid the body on him. Ball goes back to USA, 21-4 they lead. I'm Lee Felsmo, Quinn Kestick on the sideline, working our 6th of 7 broadcasts of these World Games 98. And our final one is going to be just an absolutely wonderful game. Two best teams in the nation. And then, or in the world, I should say, matching up 11 countries represented here. 10-day tournament. All comes together on Friday. U.S. working the ball very deliberately. Jesse Hubbard, right hand is what he wants, and he puts a rocket next to the goal. Hubbard, part of that fabled trio at Princeton. Hess, Hubbard, Massey. And they all graduate this year. Defenses around the country will be happy to know in the United States. It's about a 12-pass offensive set. And finally, they sting it from the far side as Jesse Hubbard just locking and loading. And he hit the net that time. This guy, one of the big-time shooters, all-time great shooters at Princeton University.
Hubbard's seen a lot of time tonight at the midfield position. You know what he can do with that right-handed cannon. That was his job at Princeton. He had great players around him in the form of Massey and Hess. And here he is out of the St. Albans School in the D.C. area. Hubbard played at Princeton, now showcasing his skills for the U.S. team. A lot of velocity. Just as a goaltender, when Hubbard starts shooting like that, I'd like to creep out towards him, cut some of his angle. There's really no way you're going to react to that shot and make the save. The ball's just traveling too fast.
Look at Hubbard, ran right over the back. Look at that hit by the Iroquois Nationals. I don't think that'll get him any favored look. That's Vince Schiffert.
Hubbard ran him from behind. Shifford upset. Look at that wooden shaft. If you can see a close-up, watch Shifford stick. Hubbard gets him right there for just a push. Watch the retaliation right there. That should be a game ejection. Okay. Look at that wooden pole, though. That is just an absolute weapon, that heavy wooden pole.
We checked one of those out on the sideline, didn't we, Quint? That is a load to carry. Reminiscent of the way sticks used to be made.
He's in the box. I got him in already.
Okay. Yeah, we got Expo. He's down there.
Okay, he's got 3 minutes.
Okay, fine. Expo.
Slash, 16. Number 16, 1 minute for Slash, White, expulsion, 3 minutes. We need a man in the box, please.
So that is an expulsion foul against Shiffert. Kind of lost his cool when he was run over. He had the penalty on Hubbard. Kind of lost his cool.
No, just told. They're not going to come out on you.
Jesse Hubbard didn't lose his cool. That was showed a lot of restraint there on the ground, not to punch back.
Who's ball?
Shiffert will have a seat for the remainder of the game. And the Iroquois,
ball.
To add insult to injury, they'll be down a man for 3 minutes.
Quint, it kind of brings up the old 20-goal rule. You know, Coach Tierney coaching this team, he had a dominant role here at the Princeton teams, 5 national championships in the 90s. He has a sort of self-imposed 20-goal rule when he's at Princeton. He remembers what it was like when he was building that team at Princeton. He was getting shellacked by all these teams. He built that team in 5 years, but he vowed to himself that when they became a powerhouse, they would never score 20 goals on a team, and he holds off the horses, and they get the 19 time and time again.
Leaf, rarely do we have a chance to talk to Sal Acasio. He's usually in the game. Sal, night off. This game tonight, a positive or a negative? So it's almost such an easy effort that you guys might lose your sharpness for the Canadians. Any thoughts?
Well, I thought it was really nice for our offense to be able to explode the way they did tonight. We got out to a 12-goal lead early, and I think our offense is clicking, and we're looking forward to playing Canada on Friday night.
When the Canadians had you guys 8-3, you bounced back the third and fourth quarter, your best quarters, and you played really solid down the stretch. What's it going to take to beat them on Friday?
We have to play a smart game, and obviously Canada is a lot better than they've been in the past. We're going to have to play a smart game. I think we did that probably for 2.5 quarters, but sometimes things get a little bit tough. If you have to understand that it's an 80-minute game, and the game's not over till the final whistle blows, and we came back and did a great job in the second half.
Sal, your recollections of here playing the World Games in Baltimore, in the U.S., from what I see, the European fans have been incredible. What's it been like on the field to play in front of those crowds?
You know, it's incredible when we played England and when we played Australia, just hearing them chanting up there, and even coming to some of the other games and just hearing how into it the fans are. It's outstanding. I think this has been a great event. It's been a lot of fun to be a part of, and hopefully we'll be able to win a championship on Friday, and we'll remember it forever.
Sal Acasio, one of the greatest goalies in the history of the sport, Leaf, looking for another championship for the U.S. squad.
He is about as good as they get, and the amazing thing about Sal, Quint, one of the amazing things about him is that he makes the transition to the National Lacrosse League. Look at that shot, just deflected beautifully by the Iroquois.
That's a good point, though, Leaf. I think actually that has really enabled him to be to take a step forward and really be separate himself as the best outdoor goalie. Remember, when you're playing indoor, the shooters are shooting from a lot closer. And his hand-eye coordination, he admits it, was honed in the indoor league after college. And that way, when he plays outside, the shots seem like they're so much further away.
Totally different.
Totally different from a mechanical standpoint,
but he thinks
that it has really trained his eyes to see the ball better.
There's no question. The shots are in your face the whole time in the National Lacrosse League. But Sal does it as well as anybody, one of the top goalies in the National Lacrosse League and certainly the top here in the United States and the world. U.S. still applying some pressure. 11 minutes left. 22-4. U.S. leads. Big shot that time by Casey Powell. Gets his own rebound. Was going in for a follow-up shot. And good stick checks by Iroquois. Put the ball back on the turf. One thing the Iroquois are neglecting to do consistently, Quint, is clear out that crease. How many times has the U.S. gotten the ball in front of their goalie, whether it be a cutting player or somebody else, and able to stand up, not being checked out? Teams are leading strike now. That 3-minute penalty over. Shiffert will not play again, but the 3-minute penalty now has expired. Teams at even strength. 10 more minutes to go in this one. United States will advance, play in the finals. Big shot from up front, and again wide from Milford Marchant. Billy Miller works from behind, gets right past Matt Alexander. One fake high, another fake high, and a great save. tremendous save out of the goal of Pat Salomon. Really stepped up and blocked a beauty right there. Two fakes by Miller. Salomon makes the stop, and here they go to the other side. Gaywash Schindler. Antsy to get a shot and takes it right away. Backed up by his teammate, Al Jones, and Jones will inbound. Well, they need a couple of fresh lacrosse balls over there, and they call a timeout with 9:52 left. Casey Powell feeling maybe a little twinge in the leg. Quint coming out of the game.
See if I can find him.
He's taking a seat. Got to be the scariest thing in the world for a guy with a knee injury, only 3.5 weeks old. Talking to Dr. Les Matthews, Quint, one of the fabled goalie tradition players here, the guys that really kind of set the tone for you and others, and went on to become an orthopedic surgeon.
And one of the best in the entire country. This is he's working in his second World Team game. Talked to him before the game. Said that Casey was kind of accelerating the whole healing process. But from all the tests they had done, he was ready to play. Not 100%, about 80%. But tough to deny Casey Powell the chance to get out there and show his skills.
Well, I think if nothing else, if he doesn't play another minute because the leg isn't 100% or maybe is threatening to get injured again, he certainly has enjoyed the World Games experience here tonight. Ball up front, watch out there and low. Nobody covering him in the middle. They'll get a shot and a goal, and then the penalty. The slash was on the Iroquois as well. 23-4.
23-4. Low stuffed earlier. This time he just zings it past the Iroquois goalie. Full velocity. Low plays with that tight pocket. Most of the time he shoots high. You can see the velocity. Leaf, I'm lucky enough, got Casey Powell on the sideline. Casey, you got to be feeling great. Two goals on the evening and a chance to play in front of this huge crowd.
Yeah, it feels great. This is one of my dreams, and finally tonight it came true, and it's an unbelievable feeling. It's an unbelievable atmosphere, and I'm really excited to be out on the field.
Behind the back goal, one of your signatures. Got to be excited. The kids will love that.
Yeah, definitely. I didn't want to come out and try too much, but the shot was there, and I took it, and I'm sure the kids will remind me of it afterwards, so it's good.
Get back 4 years from now. We think you'll see you back on the USA team?
Absolutely, and hopefully I'll be 100% to help my team best I can.
Casey Powell, such a great teammate all week, Leaf, on the sideline. You can watch him supporting his teammates, staying positive with his teammates, and he got a chance to play tonight and showed you that he is one of the greatest players in the country.
Thanks, boy.
Sensational kid. Now, here he is getting knocked around down there. Players getting hit pretty bad. Look at that. They're really throwing the wood down there, and that was the one that kind of caught his knee, and that's when he came out of the game. Timeout taken by the Iroquois. We'll take a timeout as well. 23-4, U.S. is advancing to the finals.
Bennett Earth is under attack.
Mysterious explosions.
Gigantic robots.
Who will save us now?
The Beastie Boys. Hello, Nasty.
Hello, Nasty.
The new album featuring Intergalactic.
Intergalactic Planetary.
It's the Beastie Boys. Hello, Nasty.
Hello, Nasty.
In stores now.
Now on the Jetta TDI, you can get 1.9% APR over 24 months. On the road of life, there are passengers and there are drivers.
Thank you.
The 98 World Games of Lacrosse are brought to you by Warrior. Warrior Lacrosse providing Team USA with the means to dominate. By Volkswagen. Drivers want it. By U.S. Lacrosse, the national governing body of lacrosse. And by Lexus Luxury Automobiles, the result of a relentless pursuit of perfection. Back in Baltimore, Maryland, the USA doing a great job of showcasing their talents as they move on toward the finals. Some kind of record-setting offensive show, 23-4. 7 minutes left in this game, seven and change. Lee Falsmo, Quint Kesenick, our special exclusive World Games 98 coverage continues. And the Iroquois Nationals, Matt Alexander, taking his time. Quint, they're at even strike. No, actually, they're a man short, so Alexander was just backing up. Didn't want to challenge because he had a man in the box.
Well, Alexander stepped back on sides, and Burnham on the far side was saying that he stepped over a little too quick for the box official right there to make that call. International rules, you got a box official. His job is substitutions and offsides calls.
Okay, well, in the meantime, I think it was Ron Kogan that was in the penalty box. I think he started a man short. That's why he was reluctant to go against the double team. He backed up against the double team, and then he got in trouble in the offsides. All right, folks, a good look at Coach Bill Tierney. Let's stick with Tierney for a while and just kind of hear how he's following the game at this point in the fourth quarter. Not too concerned, Bill Tierney.
Hey, fellas, hey, that's it. No more shots, all right?
I talked about the 19 goal rule,
hey.
Quint. As they score the 24th goal of the game, he puts the lid on the offense.
Tell them no more shots.
Right now, Miller with three, Watson with three, Millen with three. Watson's 3-4. And that is it for the offense for the United States.
Take a look at that last one. Spread the field, goal number 25, and then Coach Tierney said no more shots. It's a luxury we have having these coaches mic'd up.
USA gets it back. Now, they'll have possession, but they will not have the shots because the coach called them off. United States now moving around using all their great stick skills. Coach Bill Tierney said no more shots. So now they'll just be working around, trying to get possession, trying to get something out of the offense, trying to learn something, trying not to get hurt, I guess, huh, Q?
Running around in a circle.
Q, you might want to take this back and give folks maybe the reason why this happened, but until this point in international play, this position was usually manned by England. They were traditionally the fourth power, international power, and there was a major upset earlier in these games where the Iroquois Nationals beat them in the last 30 seconds on a man-up play when the goalie was injured.
Yeah, that was a great turn of events. Carcaterra tried to go coast-to-coast, caught out of the cage. He interfered with the Iroquois goalie. Then they scored on the extra man. It was a 9-9 tie. They went up 10-9 with 38 seconds to go, and that's why they advanced. First time ever that the Iroquois got out of round-robin play.
So they came into this, were challenged by Japan, the winner of the red division. That was the play-in opportunity for Japan, who went undefeated in the red division.
Japan looked great. We've got Mark Millen, who's played so well in this tournament. Day off tomorrow, and then the finals on Friday. Offense, certainly the name of the game tonight.
Yeah, we started clicking a little bit, moving the ball. I told you the other day we needed to just keep moving the ball upfield. And biggest thing, Quint, was finishing our shots. We've made some of the goalies play real. Two goalies had 29 saves against us. and we knew if we could finish our shots, we could light the scoreboard up.
You did. You scored in your first six shots and really spread it around. Billy Miller, a bunch of goals. Michael Watson, a bunch of goals. All the middies have scored. One of the keys, I think, to your success has been the fact that a lot of guys can score.
Oh, yeah. That's the thing about our team. We think we're probably the deepest team here. If we can get everybody scoring and finishing our shots, just moving the ball upfield, we think we're pretty good.
I think it's going to be quite a circus out there Friday night. Big crowd, a lot of attention. You got to be excited.
Yeah, this is what we've been playing for. I mean, playing Team USA in Baltimore, this is what we're looking forward to. It's going to be a great game.
Been a lot of interaction with the kids. It seems like every time I look, you're signing autographs or showing a kid your stick.
Well, this is, again, it's another thing about being here in Baltimore. The fan support here for Team USA, it's a very well-marketed event, and there's tons of kids around, and it's a real good event for us.
Mark Millen, we will see him in action on Friday in the finals as the world team aims for gold.
Quint, certainly a marked man. Mark Millen, the MVP in 94, but he didn't waste any time laying up the goals in the round-robin division of World Games 98. And from your vantage point in mind, not too many guys can stay with Mark Millen defensively in these international games. He has blazing speed and an exceptional change of direction.
And I tell you, on this turf, I think that is just more and more evident. You play him on a muddy, deep field, and you don't see that. But out here, when he has made that cut, there's just been no one who has been able to stay with him.
USA still working the ball around, and we've got 2 minutes left as the time winds down in this one. They have been dominant from the opening faceoff. So again, this is a Bill Tierney philosophy, and he's learned this because he was on the short end of this for several years at Princeton. One of the classiest programs in the history of lacrosse, Princeton lacrosse, winning 5 national championships in the 90s. And his coaching philosophy and style is the most mimicked and copied right now on lacrosse. Kevin Finneran eluding the double team. As time winds down here at Homewood Field, Baltimore, Maryland, very proud to be the host city of World Games 98. This has been a 10-day festival where there have been more than just 11 countries represented. There has been, as Quint mentioned, autograph signing sessions, great merchandise displays, and just a fan fest area that will occupy your whole family for the whole day. And there are still one whole day of activities left. So Friday the 24th, you're in driving distance. Get on down here and see probably the best final in the history of the game. That's going to be Friday night. Of course, it's part of our broadcast package. All right, Quint Kestick, we've got our Warburg Pincus player of the game, and I think you're within earshot of him right now.
Darren Lowe, who started so many of the plays from behind the goal tonight with a bunch of assists, and late in the game, he got in on the scoring. An exceptional performance by the U.S. offense.
Yeah, I mean, I think this was a carryover from Monday night's Canada game in the second half. We're starting to click. You know, one more game. I think in the dorm today on the way over, I think guys are starting to feel it. I mean, I've been dreaming about Friday night, the championship game and the world championships here at Hopkins since I've been a little boy. And I think that's the same for the 26 guys in this team. And I'd like to finish my career here on Friday with a championship and run around with the flag at the end of the day.
For the U.S., they're one game away right now as they beat the Iroquois 24-4. It was all offense. Leaf?
And they started quick, that 12-0 lead. They never looked back. They had a sensational game as a tune-up to the championship to defend their international title. Bill Tierney now very relaxed. Tried to, early on, maybe not the best of fit for Tierney's system. He tried to get these guys learning it in a very short amount of time. But they definitely on the right page now. They are all doing what they need to do. The team looks powerful. We'll come back with closing thoughts from Baltimore, Maryland in just a moment.
tallest mountain in North America is 20,320 feet. Cool.
As a lad growing up in the outback, golf legend Nigel Bridges showed little aptitude for sports. He wasn't very good at rugby or cricket, or so it seemed, at golf. But he tried and he tried and he tried and he tried and he tried. Until he got it right. You'll find the same dedication and commitment to perfection at Outback Steakhouse, where a great steak dinner is always just a short drive away. Outback Steakhouse, no rules, just right.
Good shot!
Luxurious Lexus ES300. All the security and comfort you're looking for at a price that most only dream of. At Lexus of Annapolis and Lynn Sterler Lexus in Owings Mills today.
Back in Baltimore, Maryland, the United States dominant tonight as the defending champions in international lacrosse, the Iroquois Nation, their first semifinal round international play. Maybe a little bit jumpy. They came in and were jumped on by the great offense of the United States, exchanging gifts, part of the tradition of international competition. And that's what they're doing right now, as they congratulate each other. This sets up a tremendous final, the best ever in the history of the game. It's going to be Canada, led by the Gates, the hard-hitting Canadians, the explosive offense of Canada against Team USA. They have it all going for them. As you see, Sanderson has made the defense more solid. USA played them just the other day in the round robin, and they came out fired up, hitting hard and winning by 3 goals. That was the round robin play. They'll go at it one more time for all the marbles, the championship game. Canada versus the United States. Friday, 8 o'clock is the live game time. A lot of opportunity on our broadcast network to watch that one. It'll be one of the best ever, I guarantee. Right now, back to my partner, Quint Kessick, on the sideline with one of the offensive stars of the game.
That's right, Leaf. I've got Bill Miller. Excellent game tonight. Just a perfect tune-up offensively for the Canadians on Friday.
That's exactly what we were looking for, was, you know, come out right away at the first whistle and play really hard. If you remember, at 3-0, there was a timeout. During that timeout, coach said, this is where we've been letting down. We get up a couple goals and we think, okay, everything's all right. And we really put the pressure on then. That's when I think we put the game away early. Then we started working on the offense, running hard. They were trying to switch up between a zone and a man-to-man. I think we had them early, and that was our game plan.
We can expect a hard-hitting game on Friday. I think penalties are key. The Canadians really hurt themselves in the first matchup by fouling. Any thoughts?
Definitely in this game, with the offensive powerhouses, the shooters that we have, the shooters that Canada has, the more man-ups are going to be in that team's benefit, and we're going to try and keep the fouls to a minimum and cash in if they do foul on us.
You guys seem to be having a lot more fun over the last 2 days than you had the first couple days. You seem to be gelling as a team.
I think that happens every year. I was on the team 4 years ago. It was the same thing, slow start. Everybody's feeling everything out. There's so many good players out on the field. You don't want to do too much too soon. Then you start realizing where your matchups are, who you can match up against, and we really, you know, tonight put it all together.
Billy Miller, big night. He's had a solid tournament. You rarely see Billy Miller with a behind-the-back shot. A guy who was solid in the nets, not much action tonight, Doc, but you were sharp, only 4 goals against. Any thoughts about playing here at Homewood?
It was just an awesome time, you know. Iroquois, even I didn't get too many shots down there, but you know, the ones that they did get, I thought I was on my game a little bit. Defense did a great job, and nothing better than winning at Homewood, Quint, as you know.
The D seems to be tightening up early on this tournament. Some sloppy defense, but you guys are looking sharp for your game on Friday. It'll be the U.S. and Canada in a rematch. Should be a great game here in Baltimore.
It started hot. It started sultry, but the U.S. came out full of firepower. They win. Halftime entertainment. That was good, too. And the goals kept coming. Big win for the U.S. as they go on to meet Canada in the finals. For Quint Kessick, I'm Leif Elsmo. We want to thank you for watching our broadcast coverage of World Games 98. One left to go, and it is two of the most powerful teams ever to play the game of lacrosse. We'll see you at the championship game.